There it is, guys.
So when it comes to prayer on a low level hardcore, I usually go a different way than a lot of people do. A lot of people like doing the blue dragons or something like that. I like doing ensouled heads with the Archaeus spellbook first, so I ended up doing some moss giant kills. Typically I do this at hill giants, but wanted to change it up a little bit. Did some moss giant kills to see if I can get some mossy keys, and I actually got three of them. But my first two were probably the worst drops that I could have gotten hands down. I got 25 steel bars from the first one and a morrential seed from the second one, which, you know, maybe I'll use the steel bars for some quests or something like that, but for now I just don't think that this is going to work out. I don't think I'm going to go back to moss giants after this. I think I'm just going to stick to hill giants for that grind, to get my prey up a little bit higher, but also just to get 65-65. At least on the third kill I got some nature runes. That gives me, you know, something to work with at least. Actually a decently valuable drop, and probably better than a lot of the ober things I could have gotten anyways, but well. Back to the hill giants, see if we can get some more prey gains. I do these in the catacombs because every time you bury the big bones, you're going to get 2 prey points back. So I actually train with the 5% or 10% strength bonus on the entire time without flicking it usually. And then I just get a little bit more DPS in while being lazy. But anyways, you know, I needed to get back to some quest grind, and for that I want some dueling rings, but I don't have a way to make gold bars right now. So I'm doing the good old, you know, under Varrock West Bank, telegrab some gold bars. And, you know, there's that ruby ring that I've wanted my whole life, but never been able to get to. Maybe one day. But anyways, let's go ahead and smelt some of these. We'll get some games necklaces, enchant these up, which the cosmic runes I got from my hill giant grind, which is another benefit of those. They also drop law runes along the way. And then we'll get to some questing. I've got the full graceful, but it would be a good benefit to have this out of the way, just so I can restore my run energy every time I get down to zero, because that is going to speed up the grind. And then we got together with the stream to do Shades of Morton, because this is actually going to be one of my ways that I get to Barrows later on. Oh, and also, if you guys didn't already know, you can actually come to Historian Manas upstairs in the Varrock Museum. As long as you've done the Shield of Varrock quest and Merlin's Crystal, you actually get 2 1,000 experience lamps, which I think can be used in any stat over level 20. So I'm going to pump up the rest of my herb lore up to level 30 with these, and then do one small favor, because that's going to take me from level 30 to 38 with the 2 10,000 experience lamps that you get from that. So that's instantly all the way up to prey pots from basically nothing, which is going to help a ton later on in the account. And then obviously this is another one of those quests I need for Recipe for Disaster anyways, because DT, Desert Treasure, is a requirement for RFD. And, well, this is a requirement for Desert Treasure. So, need to get it done, might as well get it done early, and then we can have some prey pots for the rest of our grind. And if we decide to do Barrows a little bit early on, we've got that for those as well. Oh, and when it comes to Herblore, I just wanted to mention the quest that I usually do to get those early Herblore levels without actually training a lot of herb myself. So I always start out, obviously, with Druidic Ritual and then Jungle Potion, but then Recruitment Drive is going to get you another, like, what, 1,000 experience? So I think you're at around level 13 or so by then. If you get the dig site done, you get up to maybe, what, 17 or so. Shades of Morton is another 2,000 experience on top of that. And then by that point, I really had a lot of extra, you know, herbs left over from Wintertide. So I was able to get the rest of my way up to about 28 or so from those. And then I used those 2 experience lamps to get 30. And one small favor to get all the way up to 38. By the way, this little door here, you actually don't need to go through after you finish Dragon Slayer, after you kill Elvarg. Everyone kept telling me that I didn't go through the door and I'm going to have to go back through Krandor to finish the diary and whatnot. They changed that a long time ago. You could just go through afterwards. So just teleport out of Elvarg. You don't know, like, keep having to make that run like we had to back in RuneScape Classic. Well, I wanted another way to get up to 65-65 attack and strength for the Warriors Guild. So I decided to go to Fossil Island, and I'm going to train on the Ammonite Crabs here because I can use the museum cleaning finds, you know, cleaning the unidentified fossils, to get more Herblore experience with those lower level experience lamps from the small and medium fossils that you get here. So that should help out, and it'll at least just be AFK training. All right, so the first defender's out of the way. I really don't want to bore you guys with an endless amount of Warriors Guild content. I know every single series you guys see, you have to watch people get bronze, iron, steel, all the way up, every single defender. So I think I'm just going to go ahead and skip a lot of the fun, and I'll be back on whenever I get the Dragon Defender, really. You know, I actually almost wish I recorded all of those, because this is probably the fastest defender I've ever gotten on Old School. I think this took me somewhere around an hour and 50 minutes from the bronze all the way down to the dragon drop. Not considering the time it took me to get the Warriors Guild tokens, but that was honestly just pretty beastly. I've got all these tokens left over because I actually AFK trained these while I was playing a different account on stream and just, you know, stacked up like 3k tokens anticipating this grind. So I've got like 2,000 of these left over. I'm going to continue to train a little bit here just because I want to make some money, because that's going to buy my Ivan staff later on, so we'll see what we can get. Maybe we'll get another Dragon Defender, but really just need the Rune Armor right now. Oh, and probably not too helpful of a tip, but just in case some of you guys wanted to know, the store here on the second floor of the Warriors Guild, you can actually sell a lot of the weapons, the low-level stuff that you pick up as you're doing the Warriors Guild grind. If you don't have High Elk, it might come in handy a little bit. Otherwise, I mean, you kind of have to have the item already, but it's just a quick way to do it so you don't have to go to some High Elk value general store. There's a few of them out there, which I don't think they're quite High Elk value anymore. The Taibo 1A used to be a little bit over. I think it might even be under High Elk now. The West Arty General Store is one of them, and maybe the Bandit Camp in the Wilderness is another one, but there's another option for you. Well, it seems I didn't really make enough from the Warrior Guild drops, so I had to go to the Ajil Pyramid to finish up the 200k, but since I got that and, you know, just doing some AFK training off stream now, I figured I'd just sit here at the Ammonite Crabs for a bit and, you know, see what I could really get done. Probably won't get too much, but, you know, figured a few strength levels while I'm AFK just, you know, lounging around the house should help a little bit. So I got 40 Slayer done, and that's for the Salvami. So I got the Salvami knocked out, did Haunted Mine, finished the Salvami, went all the way through Tarn's Lair, and then realized I didn't have 40 Slayer, so I couldn't actually go in there to fight Tarn, because I think it's the Terror Dogs in there you need 40 Slayer for. So I had to go back and get this Slayer level knocked out, but now I can go back to Tarn's Lair and enchant my Salvami to make it a little bit better. I think it bumps it up from 15% melees to 20%. I don't have it imbued yet, so it's not going to do anything else, but it doesn't work on the Barrows Brothers, but it does work on the minions downstairs when I'm getting kill count if I want to get 88% at Barrows. So while I'm killing the three skeletons every single run, if I want to get the additional runes, I'm going to use the Salvami for that. Maybe not the most necessary thing in the world, but it should be a good upgrade from a power ammy, because that's the best thing that I'm rocking so far. Alright, that's done, so I figured we might as well come back out here and kill one more Terror Dog, because I think this is a medium diary step. So just so I don't have to make the journey again, might as well finish this up for the time being, and we'll get out of here after that. Ah, my favorite, the Barrows grind. Okay, so I'm doing this little kiting method, and that's just so I don't have to take damage from these meleeers. I can't do it on Carol and Aram, obviously, but it's pretty simple to do on the Melee Brothers, where you're just manually casting and walking when you cast, and then running around the corner with control click. But anyways, I'll use this for the Barrows Brothers upstairs, and then just, you know, basically tank out, or if it's, you know, Carol or Aram downstairs, I'll probably just waste a prey pot on that, prey dose at least. And we'll do some runs, see if we can get some tank gear out of the way early on the account. You know, I cannot understand, honestly, why this always happens to me, but every single account I make, I swear, the first loot I get is an elite clue. And there's no way I'm going to be able to do this, so it's just a wasted loot, and it's like almost twice as rare as just getting a Barrows Brother item. So that's kind of unfortunate, but it seems like it's the same thing I run into every single frickin' time. And of course, I can't do it. Great. I started doing 100% runs just so I could try to get a half key, and I managed to get one, but I still need to get the tooth half, and that's just for the Ring of Wealth, 55 crafting plus the Dragonstone, so I can knock that out soon. Oh my god, so I lost the first clip, that's my bad. I missed the Guthan Spear, but I got that on like 16 kill count, and now we got a Veracum on 23, which is a beast tank armor piece, but I really need the plate body or plate legs, so I guess we'll roll with this for now, but hopefully we can add the plate and legs, and then I'll come back once I get my trident and probably get the Mortainer Hard Diaries done. Well, actually, yeah, I'm going to need both of those when I come back for the full Barrows grind. But anyways, this will work for now. I'll see you guys next time.